Hi, everybody. I'm Jeff Kelly. We're here at Cloud Foundry Summit 2018. And I'm joined by my guests, Eugene Lahansky and Sergey Matyukevich, who are both from Altoros. Welcome, guys. And my colleague from Pivotal, Zach Brown. Welcome to the show. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having us.
So I wanted to start talking a little bit about .NET. So Zach, you are one of the co-chairs of the .NET track here at Cloud Foundry, along with Sergey. Talk a little bit about that track, how it came about, and what it's been like at the show.
Well, so to start out a little more broadly, it's very exciting to be at Cloud Foundry Summit, where for the first time ever at any Cloud Foundry Summit, we've got a cloud native .NET track that's dedicated to that topic. And a big slew of talks in there, including some folks from Microsoft, et cetera. So that was really kind of a big accomplishment. But even before that started, we had a class where you got to learn hands-on about building .NET apps that run on Cloud Foundry as part of the pre-conference training lineup. And then there was a demo in yesterday's keynotes where they used .NET and a bunch of other cool technologies and stitched together, leveraging Microsoft's cognitive services APIs, and lit up those smart light bulbs in different colors based on sentiment analysis of tweets that were coming through in real time. So some really cool things there. And I've heard a rumor that tomorrow's keynotes will include a demo of remote server debugging on Windows 2016 on Cloud Foundry. So that's very exciting. So I think it represents kind of a turning point where .NET is finally really here at the table in a big way at Cloud Foundry Summit. I'm eager to hear what Sergey thinks about it, though.
Yeah, I was very excited to be a co-chair and help Zach to select topic for Cloud Foundry Summit. And I was actually amazed by the amount of good topics that we have. And it was really difficult to figure out what topics need to be selected and which one need to be left. And actually, I think we have very good presence here. We have a lot of good topics from companies like Travelers, and this shows that companies already start implementing .NET, and though it's new on Cloud Foundry, they're already doing this, and we have a lot of deep technical topics. We have a lot of introductory topics. So I think this should be a success, and we have already a lot of excellent reviews, and people come to us and say that okay, this, we like this, what you guys are doing, this topic was great, and yeah, I like it.
Great, and what do you think this means for .NET developers? How important is this? We're seeing this renaissance of .NET for those developers that, you know, now want to actually build cloud-native software.
As a .NET developer, it's great that right now I have an opportunity to just push my code to Cloud Foundry because, well, a few years ago, it seems like .NET was a kind of a closed ecosystem, and I really like that Microsoft trying to expand it and provide developers with a new ways to deploy their software in a more efficient way and utilize such products that previously were available mostly for Java developers. Like still to a library that utilizes a lot of products that have been available for Java for quite some time. And that this movement to open source, so developers share their code and start reviewing Microsoft code. So that's really great, and I feel very excited about it.
I just wanted to add, so Microsoft gave a talk today on the state of .NET. And, you know, we talked about them, Sergey mentioned it was previously kind of a closed ecosystem, and they really talked about open source and how Steeltoe really works well, and how Cloud Foundry is a great place to deploy your .NET. So it was really kind of a cool thing to hear coming out of the mouth of somebody from Microsoft, to embrace that open community. To deploy your .NET applications anywhere.
Yeah, I mean, it's really been a sea change at Microsoft over the last several years in terms of embracing open source, and huge change from the past. Why don't we talk a little bit about Altoros itself for our viewers who may not be familiar with the company. Eugene, tell us a little bit about what you do, and then we'll talk about some of the integrations with Pivotal Cloud Foundry and how that adds value to the platform and to developers and operations people.
So Pivotal is our strategic partner, I would say. We are working closely with them during last 3-4 years. in terms of Cloud Foundry, in terms of some other technologies. On the other side, Altoros is not only limited with Cloud Foundry expertise. We are working with a wide range of technologies. Of course, it's .NET, it's Java, it's Ruby, and many, many others. So that's why these departments, let's say, they allow us to provide some additional services, professional services, like application replatforming, modernization, containerization, and so on. So we are not only focused on Cloud Foundry, but still it's one of our main directions, let's say, where we're going. This is briefly the answer.
And so you're working with joint customers to help them on their digital transformation journey. Yes. Maybe we could talk about some examples. What are some of the things you're doing with some customers? I understand Boeing, I think, is a joint customer. Maybe we could talk about them a little bit. They actually joined us on set earlier today. A really interesting story, a 100-plus-year-old company, critical infrastructure, really, for this country and many countries with their aircraft. Tell us a little bit about what you guys are doing. Maybe, Sergey, you could start.
Basically, usually we start working with most of our customers as a part of Dojo. We are closely work with Pivotal, and we participate in both platform Dojos and application Dojos. So, and I think that was the case with Boeing as well, where we start a platform Dojo, and they like what we are doing, how we help them to automate the infrastructure, and they start asking to prolong Dojo and help more and involve more team in this process. And on application Dojos, we help our customers to move their legacy application and customize them in such a way that they can be suitable to be deployed to Cloud Foundry and actually make a real microservice applications out of this. And it's not only Boeing, for example, recently there was a Dojo in Denver at NASDAQ where we need a lot of expertise to help people from NASDAQ to reorganize their application, rewrite some code, and as far as I'm aware of, we received very good feedback about it. And the same story is about a lot of other companies, and I'm glad that we have more and more .NET related projects in our Dojos.
Right, and Zach, how does Altoros help Pivotal customers, especially on that .NET area, accelerating their journey?
Well, certainly it goes way beyond .NET. I mean, they've got specialties across various disciplines and areas. But when we partner together on delivery, then we're able to really, it's like a force multiplier. Pivotal's got limited delivery resources, and so we partner with key companies like Altoros to really take it to the next level.
Great, so as we wrap up, what's on the horizon, what's on the agenda for you guys? Let's say we're here talking in 6 months, a year. What are some of the things on your agenda, both as a company and as part of the partnership with Pivotal over the next year or so?
So I think that one of our strategic goals is to get close relationships with the companies that we are working with. So we don't want only to help them to start their platform up and running. We want to have close relationship with our customers and prolong our engagement in such a way that we become partners not only with Pivotal, but with companies that we are doing Dojo for. So I think that's one of our main goals in doing this.
Yeah, and in addition to this, I would say that we are not only interested in helping our customers to providing them some services, but we are also interested in, as you said, digital transformation. So we need to go deep into the business to understand the how it works from under the hood, let's say. And this will allow us to provide the better service and find a better solutions for this certain enterprise company.
Mm-hmm. And Zach, what's your perspective in terms of the ongoing partnership and where you think this can go?
Well, I think we're at a really exciting place in the .NET community on Cloud Foundry. And I hinted at it earlier, but what you know, there were a few Cloud Foundries where when you heard about .NET, it was about like these capabilities that are out there, but you never really got to see, is anybody using them? Is anybody, you know, they still seem sort of fringe and experimental. Well, this is the conference where we're hearing about how big companies have taken it to production. I recently got to see a list, and it included something like 50 company names of different companies that were running .NET applications on Cloud Foundry, and many of those in production. And lots of them had hundreds or even thousands of application instances up and running across both the Windows stack and the Linux stack. So we're really getting to see this time when it's moving from a technology that, yes, you can do that, to something that people are actually using and people are running in production on big public-facing, massive scale, revenue-generating web applications. And what's great is Pivotal has partners like Altoros that magnify our ability to really work with those customers to bring those applications all the way to production.
Fantastic. Well, I look forward to next year. We can have this conversation again, and I bet we'll be even further along, and we'll have some more examples of really big companies and really interesting applications running, .NET applications running on the platform. So, guys, thanks for coming. Appreciate it. I know it's a busy conference for everybody. I'll let you get back to it. It sounds like the party's starting, so I'll let you guys enjoy that. But thanks again for coming.
All right,
thank you.
Thank you, too.
Thanks.